Hi guys, I'm the Yorkshire Samurai, aka Yorkie Sam, and thanks for joining me. So this video is thanks to Dr. Flog, who commented on my Nurgle drawing, and you know, he gave me a suggestion which I really appreciate because I'm very new to YouTube, and I appreciate him taking the time out of his day to give me a bit of feedback. So this suggestion is thanks to him. So without further ado, let's get into it. So I haven't read Spawn in a number of years. I remember my friend Lee had some comics of it, and I remember it was really dark. I can remember that for definite. It was it's a very dark story, and the character is one of the examples of an anti-hero, so he is very morally grey, to say lightly. So but I do remember thoroughly enjoying it, and you know, I've nipped him from time to time in terms of like Spawn Universe to check it out from time to time. I remember watching the live action film, which was not great. It was not great at all. But I also remember really enjoying the HBO animated special, which was kind of like, I would probably describe it as Spawn done right. I think the fact of the matter is that some things, in my opinion, are better off animated rather than in live action. Not always. You know, we might one day get a really good live action Spawn adaptation. But for me personally, certain things I think translate from comics or manga to animation and anime much easier, much better than video live action. By the way, before the two people who watch this come at me with Marvel and DC adaptations and oh yeah, they're great. Marvel, I mean, I think the quality's dropped a little bit in their recent stuff, but on the whole, obviously, really, really good. But I would still argue that the MCU is very different from the Marvel cartoon shows. And of course, when it comes to DC, I think DC have, when I was growing up watching, for example, the animated Batman show with Mark Hamill as a Joker and Kevin Conroy as Batman, RIP. I mean, they were just fantastic. And I think with the MCU and the DCU, DCU, isn't it? They kind of nerf the heroes and villains a bit, but not as powerful or as much of a threat, or certain characters, they just don't portray them how they were in the comics. I mean, for example, I saw Black Adam and Dr. Fate was in that. And Dr. Fate from the comics is insanely powerful. I mean, he is one of those kind of top tier characters that could easily one-shot Black Adam easily. I mean, no one in that movie, if you're true to their comic counterparts, could lay a finger on him. But he was played very well and very charmingly by Pierce Brosnan, but just not Dr. Fate, basically. So getting back to Spawn, the reason I did this version of Violator, because I know that there are a lot of people who have done drawings of the Violator in his more kind of bestial kind of form, where he's like, you know, the kind of insectoid kind of looming monster, and yeah, that looks cool. I do like that version, but for me personally, and this is as someone who likes Spawn but is not a hardcore fan, I'm not deeply entrenched in the lore, I'm not up to date on the latest comics or anything like that, but this version of the Violator, the kind of clown version of him, It's the iconic version. It's the one that everyone thinks of. Whenever you say the Violator in relation to Spawn, this is the first portrayal of him that comes up in everyone's mind. In my opinion, anyway, it does definitely come to my mind if you say the Violator from Spawn. And also, I think this version encapsulates their relationship a lot more in terms of from what I've read and seen in the HBO cartoon, even the film, which, I mean, I don't think I'll count that really, but you know what I'm saying. It's always a relationship between them where Al Simmons, he's been murdered, his wife is now his best friend, he's in this situation where he now has his powers, he's no idea what's going on, and I do believe, I can't remember, I know this someone else, kind of a gunslinger type character, I can't remember what his name is, who helps him. But essentially, when he first is thrown into the situation, the only person to kind of give him information in the very beginning is someone who's constantly telling him half-truths, manipulation, subterfuge, lies, all while it's mocking and berating you, it's making fun of your situation, and he's reveling in, I can't say the word, reveling in it. So this whole thing where Spawn is like aggravated, he's grabbing the Violator and the Violator finds it all hilarious, I find that really does epitomize their entire relationship in like one piece. So while making this video, I did a little bit of browsing, and I never realized that there was a Spawn 2 and 3. And I'm not going to watch them because I've not really got high hopes for the quality of them. But I did notice that the main, I look at the cast, and Keith David is voicing Spawn. And obviously Keith David, he's almost as well known for his voice acting as for his actual on-screen acting. And he's got a real kind of gravitas to his voice. So I think he's going to be a great Spawn. I think he also voiced Spawn in the HBO version. I'm pretty sure he did. But also, I completely forgot about Sam and Twitch as characters. I really liked them. I really liked them a lot. I thought they were fantastic. So that's been good. And I forgot, obviously, there's Wanda. Is it Wanda? Let me double check. But obviously, Terry. I don't know, Terry, come on. That's your best mate's widow. I don't know about that. It's not cool. So I'm not one for showing my face in the video too much, or text. But while editing, I thought I'd finish everything. I thought it was all done. Everything's ready to get uploaded. And I can't believe I forgot about Granny Blake, which is an outrage. Because I mean, from the point in the story where I was, you can't forget Granny Blake, because she's kind of like this person of like, remember, she's blind with her faith, and like she has also like prophetic visions and that. So, but she's that kind of, you know. She reminds me of what's the character on Stephen King's The Stand, you know. She reminds me of her. I think she's probably based on her, to be fair, a little bit, but I'd imagine so. But yeah, I can't believe I forgot, of all people, Granny Blake. So throwing her in as well. As well, kind of mentioning Wanda, Terry. I remember rightly, we've got the daughter as well, Spawn's biological daughter. And don't they have twin? They have kids later on as well, but I'm not 100% sure, because it's been that long. It's stuff I remember reading or that my friend told me about. So, yeah. But yeah, I found it interesting because there's more Spawn media than I realised. I obviously am familiar with the comics. The first Spawn live action film, as I say, I'm not sure whether the second, and it says Spawn 2 and 3, and I'm not sure if they're live action ones as well. I don't think they are, but I can't tell. But yes, I'm familiar with the first Spawn film, and then obviously the cartoon series, which I really enjoyed. But yeah, it's interesting. But when I kind of I dropped off it quite early, I think, because my friend Lee, who had the comics, was telling me about the whole heaven hell thing and that, and how it's really this big. I mean, obviously, you get this sense of that from when I was reading it, if I remember rightly, from when I was reading it, the kind of heaven and hell thing, but they're really delving into it now in the current part of the series, which I might have to get back onto again because it sounds really good and it sounds epic. And obviously, there's the whole gunslinger Spawn thing, which I'm curious to see. I don't know if that's a one-shot, if that's a one-off, spin-off, or what. You'll have to let me know in the comments, but that looks awesome. So I need to get back into this universe, I think, because it's really enjoyable. Anyway, I'm approaching the end of my drawing and this video, so if you managed to like stay with me despite my rambling and that, thanks very much, I appreciate it. And of course, thank you once again to Dr. Flog for the suggestion and the feedback. I really do appreciate it. And you know, who knows, I enjoyed doing this, so any other suggestions for any other characters from any other universes that you want to see, let me know. But thanks again, guys. Peace. I'm in chains. I'm in chains. Pretend I can always leave, free to go whenever I please, but then the sound of my desperate call